What you are looking at is Mount Kenya, which used to not only be the tallest mountain in Africa for a time, but was also once the tallest volcano on the planet. While this volcano is long extinct and has not erupted in more than 2.5 million years, the nature of its summit rocks indicates that it once maintained a much greater height. These modern summit rocks of Mount Kenya today represents the remains of the main volcanic cone's solidified quartz pore magma chamber, which is known as the rock type syenite. That magma chamber used to exist 1,800 meters below ground, indicating that at one point Mount Kenya towered to a stunning height of 23,000 feet or 7,010 meters. Even more fascinating is that Mount Kenya, for much of its eruptive history, intermittently contained a long-term lava lake, a feature which is today only found at 15% of erupting volcanoes. This can be determined via the presence of a unique crystal-rich rock type known as kenyite. Kenyite forms when anorthoclase crystals begin growing in the lava lake but cycle in the molten pool for a fairly lengthy period of time until finally they are ejected as a lava bomb with funnel-like composition lava. If this then rapidly cools, generally through the presence of snow or water, it creates a glassy crystal-filled mass. The reason why Mount Kenya exists is due to a slow splitting of the African tectonic plate. At multiple points in eastern Africa, the crust is spreading apart to the east and west, which has formed so-called rift valleys that as low points often are filled with voluminous lakes. These weak points also act as a path of least resistance, and since the crust beneath the rift valleys are thinning, magma frequently intrudes into the crust, sometimes erupting on the surface and forming volcanoes. The first eruption of Mount Kenya occurred 5.78 million years ago when a volume of basalt lava erupted via a point source at a location 3,500 feet above sea level. As magma interacted with the area's abundant groundwater, some of the water was heated to such an extent that it flashed to steam and exploded upwards. Several ash-rich plumes were generated, only to be followed by a batch of magma which was propelled upwards by the expansion of its high gas content to create a 500-meter-high lava fountain. As subsequent weeks progressed, continued strombolian explosions occurred, and as ash fell back to the ground, it created a 200-meter-high cinder cone. Lava covered an area of several square kilometers and then the eruption ended. This process repeated more than a dozen times across a time span of 25,000 years, while at the same time this very magma began undergoing fractional crystallization, turning the basalt largely into trachyte. When this material reached the surface, it was far more explosive due to its higher viscosity, creating repeated Vulcanian explosions. As repeated pyroclastic flows occurred alongside ash emissions, thick domes and flows of blocky lava built on top of each other in overlapping layers. Eruptions soon began to occur several times a decade, and after 500,000 years of activity, a volcano with a base 100 kilometers wide had grown to a height of 4,400 meters. The composition of magma soon changed from trachyte to phonolite, leading to an increasingly steep main volcanic cone. A small caldera may have even at one point formed due to a voluminous explosive eruption as this gray-colored stratovolcano continued to climb in height. Eventually, a long-term lava lake developed in its main summit crater, creating large anorthoclase crystals and then ejecting them via bombs of lava which quickly cooled. Now surpassing a height of 5,000 meters, a flank vent began erupting 20 kilometers to the east-northeast, which would later be known as Ithanguni Peak. By 3 million years ago, Mount Kenya's summit had grown to 6,500 meters in height, while Ithanguni rose to a height of 5,500 meters. Yet, the frequency of eruptions soon waned, causing only isolated flank basalt eruptions and summit trachyte eruptions to occur. These contrasting types of moderately and highly explosive eruptions continued for the next 360,000 years until 2.64 million years ago, when the last eruption of Mount Kenya occurred, creating a blocky trachyte lava flow. During the next 2.2 million years, this extinct volcano created its own weather due to its impressive height, causing lush forests to grow on its lower slopes below the tree line. Heavy precipitation carved V-shaped valleys, but then the planet entered an ice age. A thick ice sheet up to 2,000 feet thick then developed above 10,000 feet elevation. Between 420,000 and 255,000 years ago, these glaciers absolutely bulldozed the summit of the mountain, removing mush while carving U-shaped valleys. Another episode of glacial growth began 28,000 years ago, but today, a faint remnant of these ice sheets that once covered 360 square kilometers remains. I hope that you enjoyed today's video. As a final note, I would like to thank this channel's patrons on Patreon and channel members on YouTube.